Hey guys, here's how to do the all for one and one for one achievement in BTD6, which only came out a couple of hours ago, and I figure this is the type of achievement that people might need help getting. The requirement for this achievement is to beat hard mode, and while doing so you only need to have one tower present on screen at all times. So what this means is that you can sell towers, you can buy new towers, but you only need to have one tower on screen present at all times. So you only need to do it with one tower. So you buy one tower and then that tower defends for a certain period of time. And then when that tower cannot hold on for any longer, you sell it and you replace it with another one. So before you know going into what I'm doing in this video, I need to tell you two things. The first thing is that as of right now, there is a bug that allows you to cheese this challenge, kinda. So you play a normal hard mode, and then at the last round, at round 80, you just sell all your towers and you buy first strike. So it's, you know, technically one tower, and you kinda cheese the achievement. But I expect this to be fixed very soon, so this video is showing you how to get it, you know, without using the bug. So that's the first thing. And the second thing is to always, while doing this challenge, to keep in mind that you need to sell first and buy second, because if you buy and then you sell, that means you have placed two towers and you're gonna lose the challenge, and you're not gonna get the achievement, right? So what I'm doing right now is it's already gone, but yeah, I placed the Buccaneer, and the cool thing about Buccaneer on logs is that it can solo easy mode by itself. So a 0-3-2 Buccaneer can beat rounds 1 to 40 by itself, and then, you know, upgrade it to 0-4-2 for the MOAB around 40, and then we get a sub next. Alright, so just remember to sell first and then buy. So we get a sub, and then the sub is going to be enough in defending rounds 41 to 49. And another thing that we're gonna do with the sub is we're gonna upgrade the sub to 402. And this is very important, because this is actually the hardest part, quote unquote hardest, because it's not really hard. But as you can see here, I'm microing this up. There are 45 CRMs around 46 and around 48. So we micro the sub on strong when they appear, and then when the ceramic layer is popped, we get the sub back to submerge. So this is gonna happen as well on this round. There are only 3 45 ceramics on 48, so this is very easy thing to do. You shouldn't be losing too many lives, and I'm doing this without monkey knowledge, so everything that you guys are gonna be doing is, you know, gonna be very smooth, and you're gonna be getting the you know, the timings faster than I am, right? So after we get the sub, during round 49, we're gonna sell the sub, and we're gonna buy a 420 helipilot. And this helipilot is not gonna last for too many rounds. Well, it's actually gonna last up until round 63, but we don't need him for that long. The next tower is the Spectre, so, you know, sell as at the same time that you get the cash to buy the Spectre, you buy a 024 Spectre, and the Spectre can defend by itself without losing any lives, and it's not even close up until round 80. I'm not sure if it can deal with round 80, but on the last round I sold the Spectre for first strike, and then, you know, that was it. So again, just remember to sell first and buy after that, and yeah, that's about it for this achievement. It awards with 1 monkey knowledge point, so that's kind of cool. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.